back in the kitchen this morning with Providence Monthly, who's brought us Chef Diego Luis Perez from Bodega Malasaña.
Go ahead, and we are making,
thank you, Will, Malasaña.
Malasaña.
And we're making cured sausage, or Choriza A la Sidra.
Yeah,
am I right?
Sure.
Okay, there
close
we go. Gracias.
I don't know what you said, but whatever it is, it sounds fine to me.
And I bet it's going right. to taste delicious. So where are we now with this?
All right, so let's just like heat up this guy, and then mm-hmm. we're just gonna slice up some of this, which is like, you know, here we go.
I'm gonna let you slice it up, because this is a little different.
Yeah, well, let me do that. If anybody's gonna get hurt, I'd rather it be me.
Ooh, hopefully nobody gets hurt.
Yeah,
but,
I think it'll be fine.
And you're just dicing it, really, in small pieces, and...
We're just gonna slice it, yeah.
It's just that looks
easy.
Great.
Yeah.
As is.
Yeah, you can just keep it as it is right now, and it looks great.
So let's, I think
all right,
we got
and then
our pan
we'll
hot enough over here.
Again.
All right, and then I'm just gonna throw these guys.
Having a hot pan, is that the key when you're doing this?
I think with anything, yeah. Having a hot pan is pretty, just kind of... Normally, you'd be cooking it directly with one of these guys right on there, but...
Okay.
I don't know. I'm not gonna...
Attempt that?
Yeah. And this is something that we're used to, too.
That way, everybody at home has a pan, not everybody has a cazuela.
That's exactly.
So while these are kind of going, I think we should...
Talk about the cider.
Yeah, so we're gonna be adding the cider once these guys kind of like pucker up. I don't know if anybody's ever had a Tommy's pepperoni pizza, but if you get the little cups,
so that's
kind of what we're trying to go for.
Ah.
So with this stuff, it's kind of funky. I don't know. I feel like that's been the word of the day with this stuff. But the, you have to pour it from like kind of really high up, or else you'll get a.
And what is it? Why are we doing that?
We're doing that to kind of like aerate it. We're doing that to give it like a little bit of carbonation.
Okay.
And we're also doing that because it looks pretty cool, I feel like. But
I think that's the key, though. This has no carbonation, right?
Yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
That's why the
flat machines are flat.
So
yeah, and so the other thing is you just kind of have to like pound it. You can't really like, you can't sit around with a glass of this in your hand or else, you know, it's going to get like really, really funky, right?
Wouldn't you say people in Spain sit around, they eat their tapas, and they have just little bits, like almost a shot of cider, but you sip it.
Your glass should always be empty. That's the key. Yeah. So, yeah, and anyway, so I'm going to pour a little bit of this. Yeah, there we go. See, just like
fun.
Oh, yeah, you can see it.
Yeah, so now it's all like that, and I'm just going to pour this right in there. All right.
Looks good.
And I'm going to
have a little sip, too.
So not only is it easy, but it's very simple. That's right. You want to keep the glasses empty, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
The question I have is, while this all looks cool, where am I getting this stuff? Where am I going to go to get all this stuff?
Well, you know, we're pretty lucky.
And is it easy to find?
The cider used to be really hard to find, but we've been trying to get it in here. You know, it's something which was, like, really, really hard to, when Siobhan and I opened up this bar, we were like, oh, God, we have to sell this cider, and there's a really nice guy who's got it in New York, and a good friend of ours who's a wine importer was like, oh, well, I guess, you know, I'll deal with this, you know, and so it's been good in that respect.
Soon enough, we'll be able to have it, but if people don't have this at home, is there anything that they can use as an alternative? They can't use regular cider, like cider beer, right, or apple cider or something.
No, I mean, like, you could probably, the problem with this stuff isn't very sweet at all. I mean, you could probably, cook this with, I don't know.
With olive oil, maybe.
Yeah, you can do olive oil, and then you can, maybe just splash in a little bit of apple cider vinegar. It's kind of closer to that flavor than it is anything else.
All right, so we just have a couple of seconds left. So how long is this going to simmer away?
We're just going to reduce it down a little bit, and then we're going to throw it into the
And when do we add the salt?
We can just throw some in.
Okay.
Right.
And
like
is this such
that?
An easy...
Very casual.
Yeah.
Is this such an easy tapa that you can have, and it looks delicious, it smells delicious, and I'm sure it's going to be. So we're going to try it in a little bit. Everybody at home, you can find the recipe online on WPRI.com. Click on the Rhode Show.